Can I wear the choice of my clothes? Can I go to meet my friends? Obviously, these questions will not be asked by a man. I don't want to answer these questions either. In fact, I want to question these questions. And yesterday, these questions were being asked. Today, also, they are being asked. As a police officer, I do go to various forums in order to speak regarding women's safety. In one such forum, a lady principal of a school approached me and she asked me, why don't you enforce on women not to wear revealing clothes? I kept my calm. And I said, why do you want to put restrictions on women? And she said, men are mad. Men are animals. They don't have control over themselves. Well, I said, put restrictions on the perpetrator. Why put restrictions on the women? The criminal attitude and the gender-based discrimination is directly related to the patriarchal environment in the house. The biased, lowering treatment to the woman vis-a-vis the preferential treatment to the man. There is a need to replace this patriarchal trait of subordination, subjugation, with qualitative, value-based education right at the elementary and primary levels of the school. We talk about Goddess Lakshmi, goddess of wealth, Saraswati, goddess of wisdom, Durga, goddess of courage and strength. They have been worshipped in the Indian civilization and culture since ancient times. This is an extreme form of providing honor to the dignity of womanhood. On the contrary, when we see the kind of offenses that are taking place against women, our heads should bow down in shame. The problems of women start from the womb and continue up to the tomb. My battle with the system. As an 11-year-old girl, I used to walk down from my house to the bus stop to catch the bus. On the way, there used to be this boy on the cycle. He used to pass lewd comments, drop his books in front of me, circle around me. As an 11-year-old child, I was traumatized. I asked my mother to please change the bus stop. My mother understood something is wrong. She asked me several times, is something troubling you? Is somebody bothering you? I just did not say anything to her. I denied all the time. I don't know why I denied it. Probably I didn't want my parents to be upset. It was probably a very small issue right now if you just think back. But for an 11-year-old child, it was traumatic. Traumatic enough that today also, I remember it very clearly and I'm speaking about it in this platform. I dread to think what would happen, what happens to women who go through even severe kind of harassment. I later went for my graduation to Lady Shri Ram College. And of course, I stayed in the hostel there. And it gave me an opportunity actually to come out of my cocoon. Of course, the insecurities of living in a city like Delhi was there. There were times when I was coming back to the hostel and there were vehicles following. It was scary. Back home, my parents were not getting along very well with my close relatives, and they filed and complained against them for illegal trespass and theft. The concerned police woman, inspector, came to my father and she spoke very rudely to him and insulted him. I was extremely saddened by that. And that was probably my first brush with the police. Not a very welcoming one, though. And unfortunately for her, probably, I got into the police. I got into the same cadre. I got posted in the same place. And she was under me. She did come back to me. And she told me, sorry, please do not do this to an innocent person. And probably I have also learned out of that experience myself. As an IPS officer, I have worked in various capacities, in various places throughout, initially Bihar, and then after marriage, I came to Andhra Pradesh and worked in various places in erstwhile Andhra Pradesh. When the state of Telangana was formed, the CM of Telangana, he wanted to make Hyderabad like Singapore. So he went to study the progress of Singapore, and the authorities over there, they told him, surely we'll try and make Hyderabad like Singapore, but you'll have to answer one question. Will your women be able to come out at any time of the day or night, the way our women do? And he just did not have any answer to that. He came back to Telangana, Hyderabad, and he made a committee for the women's safety and security. And there were certain IAS, senior IAS and IPS officers, of which I was also a part. We studied the entire of various sections of women in Hyderabad, their problems, what exactly are the problems which they are facing. And the most important things that, problems that they spoke about was problems regarding harassment in the public places and also in the transport, apart from, of course, domestic violence. We gave our recommendations, after studying, we gave our recommendations to the CM, and he pointed to me and he said, you will be going to Hyderabad city and you do something there for the women. I suddenly felt that, is it because of this that I am an IPS officer? I felt that that was my calling. Immediately, I formed the teams, the she teams. We got, each team consists of 5 members, mostly men, with at least one woman. It is headed by a sub-inspector. And initially, there was a lot of preparation done for the teams. They had to be prepared. They had to be passionate about what they are doing. It was not a routine policing. It's not that the police stations did not do this job earlier. But this was specifically meant for women. I told them one thing. You go back to your houses, speak to your wives, speak to your sisters, speak to your daughters, and find out how it feels when they are harassed. They did that. They came back all, you know, charged up that, yes, ma'am, we'll do it. For 1 week, we gave them all trainings, gender sensitization, how women feel face these problems. And the first day, even I went, we were all charged up. The whole, almost the entire night, we were, you know, searching. We didn't get a single person. Everyone came back dejected. I said, don't worry, you'll get a lot of people. Next time again, of course, the first case was also very interesting. They saw one person kind of troubling this girl in the bus stop. And she boarded the bus, he boarded the bus, our team boarded the bus. In the bus, he didn't do anything. The girl got down in the next to next step. The boy got down, our team got down. Then suddenly our team saw that he was trying to shove a paper into the girl's hands. That is the time when they nabbed him. Basically, our team works on evidence. We believe in evidence. They are in mufti, mufti as in they wear normal civil clothes. They are not in uniform like this. But they carry discrete cameras so that whatever incident happens in front of them is recorded for future evidence. We have to produce them before the magistrates. I tell them one thing. Please do not, I never give them targets. Get the right person, but never get an innocent person. So we're very careful about who we get. And not only that, slowly we started getting phone calls. I mean, we have given a long platform for people to approach us. We have a Facebook page, we have a WhatsApp number, mobile application, website. We have all this. Apart from that, for those people who do not have smartphones, we have 100 as the dial number. We have been going along in these lines, and after some time, apart from these raids or these catching people red-handed, we got complaints regarding phone call and social media harassment too. We started working on that too. There was one incident in which a man, he was behaving like an educational consultant. He had taken the numbers, phone numbers and the names of girls from various websites of the universities, and he had maintained 12 or 13 registers like this. He was having 21 mobile phones, almost the similar same number SIM cards. He had maintained registers service provider wise, so he didn't have to spend too much on calling also. He was calling all these girls, and these were innocent girls of probably intermediate students. And as an educational consultant, he was talking to them. For a couple of months, he used to talk to them. And then he used to call them to his so-called office, which was located in a very isolated place. And there he used to sexually assault them. Hundreds of victims were there for him, but we got only 3 complaints. That too, by chance, we came to know that all the 3 victims accused was only one. After a lot of hard work, we could trace that fellow, and we have caught him. We have booked him under serious sections of Nirbhaya Act also, and we have also put a PD Act against that person, by which he will not come out on bail at least for 1 year. After that, once he's charged, in case he's charged, it will be another sentence. We also have a Bharosa Center. This is different from the She Teams. Bharosa Center is for those, it is an integrated support center for women and children. And this is basically for rape victims and for children who face sexual abuse. Normally, when a rape happens, the victim has to undergo certain procedures. She has to be taken to the hospital for medical examination. She, 164 statement, that is the statement has to be recorded by the magistrate. A statement has to be recorded by the police. She's already in trauma, and all these procedures are also there which she has to follow. For the support of such victims, we have this Bharosa Center. This center has these counselors. They have a legal advisor. We have a video conferencing facility so that the woman does not have to go to the court and feel re-victimized again. People will look at her with that kind of a stigma. We want her to be comfortable. So in the confines and the comforts of the Bharosa Center, she's able to record, the magistrate is able to record her statement via the video conferencing facility. We have a nurse, and we ensure that the medical examination is also done. We have our vehicle with us. We take her and we bring her back. We have very good counselors who counsel them after the rape also. One very concerning thing which we have seen these days is the assault on children. And when I say children, it is both boys and girls. It is very, very, it is a concerning subject, and I feel a lot about it, and I feel that parents should also be as much sensitized about this subject. There has been, after all these initiatives, a 20% reduction in the offenses against women. 80% of people in Hyderabad are today aware of she teams and how to approach the she teams and how to take help from us. 5 states across the country have replicated she teams, and it is also functioning in various names. She teams has also been brought into the curriculum of the Telangana State Board intermediate second year civics syllabus. We just feel encouraged, and that encouragement helps us to be more responsible and behave in a more responsible manner, because I feel that our responsibility goes up further. These are some of the activities which we do. We create legal awareness camps. We conduct legal awareness camps. We conduct self-defense classes. We go to all the colleges and schools across Hyderabad. We have covered more than 200 colleges and hundreds of schools. Policing as such, if you see, is more of a legacy of the British. It is more, British used the police for subjugation and for subordination. Today, that is not the case. We can no longer behave in that way. We have to change in the police, and we are changing. In Hyderabad City Police, all our police stations today are getting renovated, and not only infrastructurally, the police personnel inside the police stations are also changing. We are training them in soft skills. We are training them how to receive petitioners. And not only that, there is a third party, who will ensure that they are monitored. They will call them up as far as any of the, randomly they will pick up a petitioner, and they will call that person and ask how the response was from the police station. And on that basis, their ACRs, their confidential reports are generated. We are also using technology for ensuring prevention, investigation, and detection. We are having CCTV cameras across the city. Our target is 1 lakh CCTV cameras across Hyderabad. We have already covered 30,000. And that is being done through People's Public Partnership. So definitely, we we want that the public also support us in these initiatives. Police cannot be there everywhere. We have also launched a Hawkeye mobile application which makes public a citizen's police. There are functions in that whereby you can take a picture and send it to us and we will do the rest. So we just want that even the citizens be a part of our policing so that we can have a better society. It is seen that 15 to 20% of people behave irresponsibly. That is, they are the criminals. What about those 75 to 80% of people? Why do they have to just sit back and do nothing about it? It is time that we all come together and do something for the society. If not anything, at least call 100. It is definitely not a women's issue alone. We've seen that several times. Every household has a sister, a wife, a daughter, a mother. Everyone has to come together and work towards that. Or should I say it's about time that we all come together and work towards having a good society? I will end with a quote from Albert Einstein. He says that the world will not be destroyed by those who do evil, but by those who watch them without doing anything. Thank you.